Good day to Dinarans on the go and in the know, October 26, 2019, no hype, no BS, just the facts. Hit the like and subscribe buttons so you don't miss out on my next post. I encourage you, knowledge is power, stay informed and stay alert, and know that today, we are one day closer than yesterday. First article of interest, latest MNT Goat newsletter, October 26, 2019 MNT Goat news brief. Hi everyone. I bring you some news today. So, there is not much news to report today. We know today the protests are demonstrating again, but this time the numbers are much more. Each time they must hold these demonstrations, the crowds get larger and larger. Today I am going to let you know what is holding up the reinstatement of the Iraqi Dinar. This is nothing new and I have told you about this before, but today I will talk in technical terms and I hope you all will understand. We heard news in December 2017 that final Union Chapter 7th sanctions has been lifted. What does this mean? Many were excited and hoped this would also release the currency. We all thought, me included, that this would free up the monetary system for Iraq and allow them to reinstate the currency. But this is not the case and here is why. In the recent past I told you it is the US that is holding up the final steps. How can this be? Many debate that the US is involved. So, let me show you now how the US is involved in holding up the reinstatement of the Iraqi Dinar. OFAC sanctions. What are OFAC sanctions? The US Office of Foreign Assets Control, OFAC, is responsible for creating, implementing and enforcing the United States sanctions. All parties under U.S. jurisdiction must abide by OFAC sanctions and associated regulations. This is all over the news now with the Iranian sanctions. But this is not the only country to have OFAC sanctions in place and still enforced. Transactions that are subject to OFAC. All of the following types of financial transactions should be reviewed for OFAC compliance: deposit checking and savings accounts, loans, credit cards, wire transfers, ACH transfers. So, if you have been paying attention to the banking reforms over these past years, you know that Iraq has already prepared themselves for the day when these sanctions will be lifted, but not yet. The Office of Foreign Assets Control, OFAC, of the U.S. Department of the Treasury administers and enforces economic and trade sanctions based on U.S. foreign policy and national security goals against targeted foreign countries and regimes, terrorists, international narcotics traffickers, those engaged in activities related to the proliferation of weapons of mass destruction, and other threats to the national security, foreign policy or economy of the United States. This is why Iraq has the currency auctions and must continue the auctions until the OFAC sanctions are lifted. Unfortunately, as time goes and the delay in lifting these sanctions continues, more and more corruption ensues within these auctions. Billions of dollars are lost to the corruption each year. OFAC may also implement United Nations Security Council resolutions, UNSCRs, with regard to the Iraq-related sanctions. Executive Orders 13668 ending immunities granted to the Development Fund for Iraq and certain other Iraqi property and interests in property pursuant to Executive Order 13303, as amended May 27, 2014. The bottom line is the U.S. must lift OFAC sanctions against Iraq or the banks will not be exchanging our Iraq dinars. This is something, as dinar holders, we all need to be aware of and look for. We need the U.S. to take off these sanctions. No, this has nothing to do with UN Chapter 7 sanctions. These are in addition to the UN sanctions. This is in dealing with the U.S. banks. What about these premature exchanges many of these gurus claim have already happened? Yes. They are illegal and, if true, these politicians from 2012 to 2013 under the Obama administration must be held accountable for disregarding OFAC sanctions, just like you and me or the banks would be held accountable under the law. There are specific legal penalties for disregarding these sanctions. More news. Prime Minister Adel Abdul Mahdi received on Wednesday U.S. Defense Secretary Mark Asper. The Asper arrived on Wednesday morning to the capital Baghdad and met with Iraq Defense Minister Najah al-Shammari. What do you think they were talking about? Will they negotiate down these sanctions in order to allow U.S. troops in Iraq again? Okay, so you are so smart, as there are already U.S. troops in Iraq. But does Iraq really want them there? What about the status of forces agreement so far already in place? Have you forgotten about this? So what the U.S. news media is pumping is yet just another way to put down Trump and make him out to be a bad guy. They are not telling you the truth. Get it? Auf Wiedersehen. Much love to you all. Mounts and Goat. Next article of interest. The Ministry of Finance announces good news in the 2020 budget. 26th October, 2019. The Ministry of Finance announced that the budget law for the next year, which has achieved advanced stages of discussion, has not adopted a fixed price per barrel of oil so far, and the daily export of 3,800,000 barrels, the share of the Kurdistan region of which 250,000 barrels, confirming the keenness of all the authorities should adopt the next budget, provide services, compensation and salaries to citizens to contribute to improving the living and economic conditions of the country. The semi-official newspaper quoted the Undersecretary of the Ministry Dr. Mayor Hamad Johan as saying that the budget for the next year 2020 will be unconventional, as it relied mainly on providing services and the needs of citizens across the country, stressing that it is under study and will last between 4 to 5 stages to reach its final destination, noting that the basic idea depends on how to provide the necessary funding to meet the needs of citizens and compensation and salaries. In addition to the success of the government program of the state, he added that the budget law for the next year has not yet adopted a fixed price for Iraqi oil exporter, but there are proposals submitted adopt a price ranging from $50 to $56 per barrel, including oil allocated from the Kurdistan region of Iraq and 250,000 barrels per day, indicating that the financial budgets, each of them a certain specificity, and therefore the House of Representatives may put any other amendment to modify the direction of the share of the Kurdistan region of oil produced there, or any amendment another in its code, on the mechanism of filling the deficit in the current budget 2019. Johan disclosed that part of it was addressed through loans in the original budget, the other part was through the cash already available in the Ministry of Finance, while part of the deficit will remain until the end of this year, will be on account for reducing expenditures on everyone, noting that the fiscal deficit for next year's budget is unclear. Landmarks yet, he promised government banks in the country, one of the tools of the state to solve any financial forms, whether to pay the deficit or even revitalize the economic movement in the country, but its potential remains limited by the amount of funds available to them, pointing out that the state has used a large part of it during the past years, indicating given the situation in the country, any amount that banks are offering to the state transparently will be part of the country's ongoing economic reform and growth. Next article of interest. Deputy Abdul Mahdi will not be able to implement his government program soon. 26th October, 2019. Jassim El-Bakati, a member of the Wisdom Movement, said on Saturday that the current government is unable to implement its program since its formation, indicating that Abdul Mahdi will be hosted soon in Parliament. Al-Bakati told the information that Prime Minister Del Abdul Mahdi will not be able to implement the demands of the demonstrators because of the pressure of political blocs to participate in Parliament. He added, Abdul Mahdi is fully aware that the file of ministries and positions in which a large share of the parties and political blocs and therefore this embarrassment generated confusion and mismanagement clear in his work. He continued that members of the House of Representatives are heading to host Del Abdul Mahdi echoes of his failure and his ministerial team in the performance of the task assigned to them. Since Thursday evening, RAK has witnessed a turbulent situation as a result of demonstrations demanding services, as the Office of the High Commissioner for Human Rights on Saturday documented the burning of government buildings by people who tried to distort the demonstrations on its peaceful path. Next article of interest. Presidency of the Parliament. The Council continues its work to achieve the demands of the demonstrators according to a specific time limit, October 26, 2019, 1745. The Presidency of the Council of Representatives said on Saturday, the Council continues its work until the demands of the demonstrators in accordance with a specified time limit. This came during a meeting, on Saturday, a meeting to discuss the latest developments demonstrations in the country. The Presidency of the Council in a statement received Euphrates News a copy that the meeting examined the immediate implementation of the decisions of the House of Representatives and ministers, and request the Presidency of the Republic and the government to send important bills urgently, which includes real remedies to the demands of the demonstrators. It called for extraordinary measures to be taken by the Supreme Judicial Council and the executive bodies to prosecute corrupt individuals who have harmed public funds and state institutions. In Article 61/VII in the Rules of Procedure of the House of Representatives, the presidency stressed the suspension of the work of the provincial, district and municipal councils in accordance with the provisions of Article 4 of the Law of Governorates not organized in the territory of Number 21 of 2008, as amended by the Legal Committee, together with the signatures of more than one-third of the members of the House of Representatives, 20, of the Law of Governorates not organized in a region, provided that according to the legal procedures for that, he pointed out to the demand of the Commander-in-Chief of the Armed Forces to identify places of demonstration, and that the security authorities take full responsibility to protect peaceful demonstrators and the protection of public and private property, and the need to distinguish between the demonstrator with the rightful and legitimate demands to be implemented and hunting for troubled water who seek to spread chaos in the burning of state institutions and encroachment on property, public and private. The presidency called on the security authorities to deal firmly with those who tamper with the security of citizens, and to take action against those who do not belong to the demonstrators and their legitimate demands in connection with what has been determined by the Supreme Judicial Council. The presidency concluded its statement by stressing the continuation of the House of Representatives to follow up the realization of the demands of the demonstrators, and the application of real measures that touch the needs of citizens according to a specific time limit and proceed with the legislation of laws and reform measures that will arrive from the presidency of the Republic and the government. Next article of interest. UN Helbesi, Parliament must carry out its duties to fulfill the demands of the demonstrators. October 26, 2019, 1916, Baghdad. The Special Representative of the United Nations in Iraq, Ms. Hans Blanchard, called on the House of Representatives to carry out its duties to fulfill the demands of the demonstrators. This came during a meeting with the Speaker of the House of Representatives, Mohamed Helbesi, on Saturday, Blanchard. During the meeting, they discussed the latest political and security developments and demonstrations in the country. A statement from his office said, he added that the meeting stressed the need to expedite the fulfillment of legitimate demands of citizens in accordance with a specific time limit, and improve public services, and work to eliminate corruption and spoilers, and take legal action against them and resolve this file, and create an environment for growth, and provide employment opportunities. He also urged the meeting to maintain peaceful demonstrations, and the obligation to preserve public and private property, and not to attack demonstrators and security forces, and to prevent saboteurs from creating a gap between them and create a state of chaos that weakens the momentum of true demands, and the need to hold accountable the perpetrators of violence, and the imposition of the law. She expressed deep concern about armed groups working to undermine stability in the country, which negatively affects the right to peaceful demonstration and fulfill the legitimate demands of demonstrators for change in the ability of the government to work to meet those demands, and stressed the importance of the House of Representatives to fulfill its duties to realize the legitimate demands of the demonstrators, while revealing the willingness of the United Nations to provide the necessary assistance in this context. More articles of interest to come. Hit that subscribe button and the alert bell so you don't miss my next post. I encourage you, knowledge is power. Stay informed and stay alert. Over and out for now, the Dinarayan.